Hello, musicians. Thank you for joining us. Scary Halloween time. This is part of our Scary Sounds series that we're doing, and it's all to make scary sounds for Halloween. Now, that we just heard was the demonic laughing tutorial we did a little while ago on Audacity, so you can be sure to check that out at this link right here. Now, today, we're going to be learning how to make the scary talking sounds in Audacity, and this is really easy to do. So let's get started. Start up Audacity if you haven't got it already started, and we're going to record ourselves doing some talking. Okay, here we go. Would you like some candy? There you go. Now I'm going to erase a little bit of silence at the beginning, and I'm going to leave a lot of silence at the end. I'm going to get rid of my click. I don't need the click because that was a mouse click there. So the silence at the end there, this part right here, is going to help us with our reverb a little later. So we're going to leave a long tail of silence there. Now, next thing what I want to do is I want to do like four tracks of whispering. So let's just try it. First of all, I can't remember what I just said. Would you like some candy? Okay, so would you like some candy? Okay, here we go. Let's try some whispering. Would you like some candy? Let's try another one now. Would you like some candy? And another one. Would you like some candy? And one more for good luck. Would you like some candy? Okay, now first thing I'm going to do is my dirty old clicks there. I'm going to get rid of those. I'm sorry for being noisy here. You know, I'm my studio's a mess. I don't know if you can see around behind me, but oh man, it's a mess here. I'm in the middle of a couple of recording projects, and you know the way things get. It gets pretty messy here pretty easily. So now we have our original track right here. And we have a whole bunch of whisper tracks. So I'm going to make these whisper tracks a little small so that I can see what I'm doing. So I'm going to make those a little small, and that one there too. Now I want to make, by the way, let's just have a quick listen to see what we have. Would you like some candy? It's sounding pretty cool already. I that sounds pretty slick. We're going to do more with it to make it sound even scarier in a minute. Now, what we're going to do now is I'm going to take this track, the top track, speaking track, and I'm going to copy it. Copy, and I'm going to go down to the bottom section here where there's no data, and I'm going to go edit paste. So that'll give me two. I'm going to do this twice. It'll give me two exact copies of the first one. And paste again. Now I have two exact copies of the original one. And if I wanted to, I could move those up so that they're a little closer to the first so I can work on them together. There you go. And you see how I did that. It's grabbed the tab here on the side and you can move them up and down between tracks. So there you go. So now this one right here, I want to make this one into a high sounding one. So much like in the other tutorial on how to do the demonic laugh, I'm going to do change pitch. So I selected the data right here, as you saw. I slid my mouse across it. I'm going to say change pitch. And I'm going to raise the pitch by around 25% and click OK. And now I'm going to take the third track. This was the second duplicate. And I'm going to select the track again. I'm going to go effect, change pitch. And I'm going to lower that one by around minus 25. Let's say minus 30. Yeah, 29. That's fine. Now let's have a listen.
Would you like some candy?
Now that sounds pretty cool as it is. That sounds pretty cool. Now we can do more changes with this, and we will in a second. This may be good enough for you. You may like it this way. But now what I'm going to do as well is I want to make these sound a little bit like off, because right now they're a little too close together. So I'm going to take the high one and make it a little bit. I'm going to move the high one right there. I'm going to move the low one a little bit later. Like that, just a hair later. Now they'll be a little bit off, out of sequence, because otherwise they sound like a choir.
Would you like some candy?
There you go. See, so you can hear the last one. The lowest one was the last one to be heard.
Would you like some candy?
See, so it's sounding pretty cool now. Now this right now is all in mono, which means that it's dead center in my headphones. I'd like to spread it around a bit, so if we have speakers around, it'll sound like it's coming from different parts of the room. And that's kind of that's really cool because if you do, even if you have like a portable radio, a portable stereo, having it separated in stereo is going to make it sound really cool. So what I'll do, I'm going to I'll leave the first one in the center. I'm going to put the high one, which would be track two, almost all the way to the right, and I'm going to put the low one almost all the way to the left. Now I'm going to open these up a little bit more again by just grabbing the bottom. And I'm going to put the first whisper all the way to the right. I'm going to scroll down a little. Open it up a little more again. Oops, sorry. Open up the next one. I'm going to put the next whisper track all the way to the left. And then the last whisper track I'll leave in the center. Actually, I've got four. Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot I had so many. That's good. Even better. I'll put this one part of the way to the right. And then I'll put the other one part of the way to the left. A lot of tracks here. It's hard to follow. All right, there we go. And a part of the way to the left. Now let's have a listen. If you don't have headphones on, it's worth your while to put some headphones on to listen to this. Here we go.
Would you like some candy?
Pretty cool. Pretty cool. Now, and again, this might be good enough for you. This may be perfect for you. And if so, great. If not, you want a bit more? Let's go to Edit, and we'll go down to Select All. So Select All. That's going to select all the tracks. And now I'm going to go Effect, and I'm going to go down to G-Verb. You can get other reverb units, plugins for Audacity. I'm going to use G-Verb. You can choose your own, whichever your favorite flavor is. Let's see a preview and see what it sounds like. There you go. Sound pretty cool. So if you like that, you can play with some of these settings to maybe make it sound a different way. Completely up to you. And click OK. It's going to apply it to all of them. Now I'm going to rewind and listen to the final version. Here it is. Scatty, very scatty. So there you go. Now the last thing you'd want to do is File, Export. And you would export this. I'm not going to bother with the metadata, but you would export this most likely as an MP3 or a WAV, whichever you like. If you're going to mail it to somebody on the internet, MP3. If you're going to go for highest sound quality possible, use the WAV files. Put it on a CD and things like that. Use WAV files. So there you go. That's it. It's so demonic sounding thing. Ooh. If this helps you out, if you like this, hey, give me a thumbs up. Give me a like. They really help me in the channel, so do me a like. And this is one of several scary sound series tutorials. So keep on track of these. Subscribe. And you'll be notified when this new one's put up. So subscribe to the channel. Make sure you give me a like. And favorite this if you like too. Okay, stay tuned. And I'll see you next time. Bye for now.